Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Now in verse number 4, children of Rome was no blemish.
Mao ni ang ilang gi carried away captive. If I was there, I would not be included. And if you're not included, then you will be beheaded. And then what else? But well favored and skillful in all wisdom, that's not me. And cunning in knowledge, that's not you either. And understanding science, and such as had ability in them to stand in the king's palace, and whom they might teach the learning and the tongue of the Chaldeans. Now, this is the danger of captivity. First, the Bible says the last phrase, and whom they might teach the learning and the tongue of the Chaldeans. They are going to teach Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego, Daniel the learning and the tongue of the Chaldeans. This is the danger of captivity. First, they are going to change your speech. Once the devil gets a hold of you, the devil will change your speech. So, Kristohanon, we should be very careful na dili ta madakpan sa yawa. Amen? Kaya kung ma-carried away captive ka sa yawa into the world, it's very dangerous because the world, the flesh, the devil, that's your enemy, they will change your language. Amen? Usbon nila ang imong speech. Usbon nila ang imong inistoryahan. Unsa man diay ang imong speech karon? Your speech, when you talk to someone, you talk to someone about the Lord. But if the devil get a hold of you, makaptive gani kasayawa, usbon na niya ang imong speech. Unsa naman ang imong speech? The Bible says, let your speech be always with grace, seasoned with salt. That's when you are with the Lord. But if the devil get a hold of you, then he will change your speech. Daghan na kaayo ang mga yaga-yaga. Daghan na kaayo. Grabe tawag, gitawag na ang mga green jokes. That's the work of the devil. So, kids, next week, you are going to enter into the realm of the devil. You're going to a public school. That's the devil's realm. Don't let the devil change your speech. Kids, amen? Still, you have the freedom to talk about the Lord. Don't let them get a hold of you to talk about something else but the Lord. Invite them to church. Come to church. Tell your friends. They need the Lord Jesus Christ. Don't ever let them change your speech. Humbili lang sa mga kids, kanato mga Christians. Amen? Sa atong work, sa atong friends, sa Facebook account, even in your messengers, don't let it change your speech. Amen? You can still post something about God and His Word. Say, kugihan kita mag-post about pagkaon, mao ni akong sudan sa breakfast, nag-post dito na ay marang, nag-post dito na ay rambutan, yung wala gyud naka-post sa pulong sa Ginoo, may pa-i-post-post ninyo na yung cellphone. I-post-post na lang. Diba? So, Kristohanon, don't let the devil get a hold of you. They'll change, the devil will change your speech. Your friends will change your speech. The tongues of the Chaldeans, that is a worldly knowledge. That's, it's good to have a knowledge of the world, but don't let it ever change your speech. It's good to know something about someone, but don't let it change your speech. And then, and so bagaimana dia? The tongue of the Chaldeans, that's basically the wisdom of the world. Mabdo mo sa public school, you will learn the wisdom of the world, and that's good. But don't let it change your speech. Ayag yun usbang imong pinulungan. Don't be embarrassed to pray in front of someone before you had your lunch. Don't let it change your speech, your habit, your good habit. Don't change it. Before you eat, make sure that they'll see you nga nagapray ka before ka magkaon. Muna ang good example. So, una, Kristohanon, that's the danger of captivity. They'll change, the devil will change your speech. And if you are in a godly realm, God get a hold of you, of course, God will change your speech from being a worldly tongue into a godly tongue. And that's what we need. Amen? Nga natay, pulong mugulang guwa sa atong ba-ba, nga nay kaalam nga gikan sa Ginoo. Verse number 5, unsa pa kitang iyang i-change? The danger of captivity. Verse 5, and the king appointed them a daily provision of the king's meat. The king appointed Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego daily provision of the king's meat and of the wine which he drank. Second, in verse number 5, the danger of captivity, it will change. It changed their diet. What is diet has to do with Christians? Well, if you don't want to talk about physical diet, let's go to spiritual diet. Siguro, wamantay, the Bible talks about what God hath kanabitawang cleanse. It's cleanse. You can eat what you want. But that's different in the Old Testament with the Jews. They're not supposed to eat katubitong mga prohibit sa Ginoo sa ila. But in the New Testament, salamat sa Ginoo nga sa atong diet, may problema. But what about your spiritual diet? The devil will change your diet. You know how the devil changed your diet? From reading your Bible, if the devil get a hold of you, he will hand you a phone, and then the devil will tell you, just read your Bible from your phone. The devil is going to change your diet. And don't let the devil change your diet. There is danger in reading the Bible from a cell phone. Once the cell phone ring, then let me check it out. And then it will get a hold of you. You're never going back to reading your Bible. So don't let the devil change your spiritual diet. Amen? We should be reading our Bible and not our cell phone. Not the cell phone Bible, but the Bible. Amen? Moni ang atong ikinahanglan. Kay delikado man gyud ang cell phone. Na dayon mo appear dito, mo tingog dayon, makuha ang imong attention, and you will be tempted to what is going on. Diba? So, ang ilahang food, sa pagyod, ang wine, well, the juice. Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego, and Daniel, they had wine. But what is the difference between the king's wine and the wine that they had? Well, the wine that they had, the Bible talks about the fresh, saan to? Blood of the grape. You squeeze the grape, then the juice is there, that's the wine. But the king's wine, unsa naman to? It's alcoholic. It's fermented. The fresh grape, it's not fermented. So the wine was changed. Be careful. Kristohanon, sa food nato, sa atong imnon, we should be careful. Well, ang atong drink is, atong food and drink is, this is the food and the beverages that we have. Amen? And this is what we need. Jesus said, I'll give you the living water. It's right here. So don't let the devil change your food and your drink. Because the Bible is all I need. All I need. Ano talaga yung kinahanglan? Don't let the devil deceive you into thinking that cell phone is more important than the Bible. Because the Bible is more important than the cell phone. Ano, Kristohanon, don't let it change your diet. Kids, if you have a cell phone, spend more time with your Bible than your cell phone. Don't let the devil change your diet. Amen? Kung wala pa kayo phone, that's good. And if the Lord grant you with a phone, don't change your diet. Stick to the book. Stick to the Bible. Don't let the devil change your diet. Verse 7. The danger of captivity. Daniel chapter 1 verse 7. And to whom the prince of the eunuchs gave names. For he gave unto Daniel the name Belteshazzar. And unto Hananiah Shadrach. And unto Mishael Meshach. Naba ko nalaktawan? Daniel Belteshazzar. Unto Hananiah Shadrach. Unto Mishael Meshach. Unto Azariah Abednego. You know what? Christians are very familiar with Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. But by the way, what are the Hebrew names? You don't even know. You know why? Because the devil changed their names. And we are familiar with the names that was given by the world to Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego, but their names were Belteshazzar, Hananiah, Mishael and Azariah. Daniel is Belteshazzar. That's the worldly name. Ang iyahang name, Hebrew name, Daniel. Gilis lang siya Belteshazzar. We should not be calling him Shadrach. We should be calling him Hananiah. That's his godly name. Kailagid to ni Shadrach, Meshach, ug Abednego. We are familiar with Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. But no, their names are Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah. That's their godly name. But the devil, during the captivity, changed their names. What are their names again? Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah. Make sure you familiarize the names that God had given them. Daniel, kinsa ganito? Four, kinsa tong upat ka name? Daniel, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah. Don't let the devil change your names. Amen? Ayaw ipausap ang imong ngalan. Adto ka sa kalibutan. Uy! Ano yung palahubog? Oh? Palahubog niya itawag si mo ha? Nanang maoy! Ano sa kaya itawag si mo ha? Nanang hambugiro. Ayaw ipausap ang imong ngalan. Amen? dapat ang ngalan i-address nila sa tuwa, Christian. Nauban, ang ngalan yung tawag sa mga Baptist. Don't be proud to be called Baptist. Kung naman tawag sa mga Baptist, badlo nga ina nga, dili ko Baptist. I'm a Christian. Yauban, they are very proud during the Baptist day. I am proud, I am Baptist. No, you're not. You are a Christian. Even Iglesia ni Cristo, they had in their door, I am proud, I am an Iglesia ni Cristo. Nasa ilang doors, sa ilang yun sa, ibabaw silang door. I am proud, I am an Iglesia ni Cristo. Well, nothing good with being proud. But, we are thankful we are a Christian. We are thankful God make us a Christian. God saved us. You should be thankful that He made you His children. So, don't ever let the devil let your classmates will not call your name. Don't let it happen. Don't let them change your name. Ingnan ninyo sila, ang akong ngalan, I am Benaya. Kasi pag-abot na ito, tawagun ka nila nga, sa itawag, Pastor! Ay, na yung mga yagayagaw, makabalo sila nga, Pastor, yung papa, tawagun din kanilang Pastor. Badlungan mo, ang akong ngalan, si Benaya. Dapat, kabalo mo mo badlung. Di mo mag-hesitate. Ayan yung itugot na mag-bully sa inyo. Kaya ang devil is very bully. Don't let them change your names. Amen? We are Christians. We are Christ ones. Without Christ, I am nothing. So it's only Christ that makes us something. Okay, without Christ, a Christian is nothing. So don't let the devil, don't let captivity, don't let your classmates, don't let the world change your name. You have a name, you have a title, and our title is that we are a Christian. And that should be our title. We are an ambassador for the Lord Jesus Christ. But if you are not a good representative of the Lord Jesus Christ, don't tell them that you are a Christian. Kay maulawan ra ang ngalan ni Ginoong Hesukristo. So makita, nakita nato, that is the danger of captivity. That captivity will change your speech. The devil will change your speech. He will change your diet. He will change your name. Don't let the devil do so. Ato yung ipabilin ang atong ngalan. Ato yung ipabilin ang atong spiritual diet. Amen? Don't let cell phone get rid of your Bible. You should be gripping, holding your Bible as tight as you can. Tighter than your cell phone. Don't let them change your language or your speech. Avoid green jokes. At mo sa eskwelahan, daghan na kayo na ito, mga yaga-yaga, na ano mo matunaan dito? Ayaw yun na ninyo itugot nga mausab ang inyong speech. Dapat ang pulong sa Ginoo should be our speech. Let your speech be always with grace, seasoned with salt. How? This is the answer. That your speech is always with grace, and it's seasoned with salt. Have you tasted something without salt? Is there a taste to a white of an egg? Job says. Is there a taste to the white of an egg? The answer is no. You need salt. Is there a taste to your life without Christ? Nothing. But pasalamat ah, that in Christ, our speech is always with grace, and it's seasoned with salt. May God bless His holy word. Let's pray. Dear God, we thank you, Ginoo, for your word tonight that reminds us of the danger of captivity. Help every Christian, Ginoo, not So let the devil get a hold of us, because the devil is going to change our speech. He will change our diet, even our spiritual diet. He will change our name. Thank you, God, for giving us a name, a good name. The name of a Christian, where it is you that we represent. It is Christ that the Christians will represent, Ginoo, sa aming kinabuhi. Kaya Ginoo, magpanalangin sa iyong pulong, mapabilin sa iyong kasing-kasing sa Panesos. Amen. Let's all stand, tindog tatanan, and let's sing a hymn, closing hymn.